Sky says, I have a client that is a division of a very large company. I'm wondering, if I can add SameAs Schema for multiple Twitter and Google Plus accounts. One account being the division, the other account in the main company. The company owns divisions in many different industries, so I'm wondering if I could gain lose trust flow because of the broad topics and if multiple accounts would confuse Google. I wouldn't do that, Sky. What I would do is if you want to be more specific with your SameAs attributes, and guys, he's talking about semantic markup using the SameAs attributes. You can go to schema.org and look it up. What the same as attributes are, but what I would do, Sky, in this situation is I would use. I'm assuming it's a WordPress site, and you can use a plugin that will allow you to inject different scripts or codes in different pages headers, so that it's not just a site wide. So, for example, a JSON-LD markup will typically go in the head section of the website, but it'll be site wide. So you go to your header.php file, you insert the JSON-LD script. And it will be a site-wide script, so it'll read on every page or load on every page. But what I recommend doing in something like this, it would be the same as if you've got one website, but you've got multiple locations and multiple location pages. You wouldn't want to put the NAP, right, the local business schema.org markup, on for all locations in the header of the site, because that would definitely confuse Google. So the same as attribute, I would treat it the same way. I would use a plugin to inject specific same JSON-LD markup, schema.org markup into specific pages. So in this case, if you've got a site that has multiple divisions, for let's say division A, I'd have one JSON-LD code. And then for division B, I'd have another JSON-LD code, and I would insert those in those division pages on those websites. But for the site-wide JSON-LD markup, I would just use the main corporate social profile. The URLs for those is the same as attributes. Because otherwise, you don't want to spam that stuff, guys. And if you add, you certainly can add too much stuff in schema.org, so I always try to keep it separated as much as possible. It doesn't make sense to add a bunch of different divisions. It wouldn't look right, because you're trying to tell Google, hey, and that's what we talk about with the question I was answering for James here is, when we create our networks, we're creating these relationships between all these properties. We're not trying to hide footprints, guys, like a lot of people do, right? We're trying to claim our footprint. We're saying, hey, this is us. These are all of our properties. Yes, we're interlinking all these properties because these are all of our – they're extensions of us. They're extensions of our brand. So in the JSON-LD, using the same as code, the markup in the you wouldn't want to tell them, hey, Google, look, we're also over here, and we're also over here, and we're also over here, we're also over here. It wouldn't make sense as far as, like, four Twitter accounts and things like that. So I would use just the corporate stuff for site-wide, but then I would inject specific code into each division's page. I'm sure there's some sort of silo structure on that site, or some way that the site is, a hierarchy of the site that you could inject it that way. Hopefully that makes sense. If you can't do that, then I would just recommend sticking with just the corporate same as attributes, and that's it. Don't go with all the other stuff. Just leave those out. Does anybody want to add to that?
I think you nailed it.
There's a plugin. I've got it in one of my spreadsheets, but it's add code to header plugin or something like that. I've got the name of it saved in a spreadsheet because I use it a lot.
I use insert headers and footers.
Yeah, but that's not page specific, though, is it? I think that's site-wide.
That's site-wide, but, well, I don't know. I'll have to double-check.
Yeah, there's a plugin that I use. If I can think about it, there's a plugin that I use, and it's, if I pause my screen, I could go find it real quick. But anyways, it'll add. In fact, let me just do that real quick. And the reason I say that is because I know this question comes up often. I need to bookmark it anyway, so just give me one second, guys.
Probably add it to the plugin area.
Yeah, probably. Let me check. Here we go. Almost there. Just a second. Here we go. OH add script header footer. That's what it is. Here, let me grab it. We'll go Google it. I'll grab the screen back from you guys. or for you guys, and you can see exactly what I'm talking about. All right, this is the title of it here. I can never remember the name for some reason, but this is it. It's called the OH Add Script Header Footer Plugin. Okay, it's free to use. Here it is. OH Add Script to Individual Pages Header Footer. Okay, and this is, you can inject a different JSON LD code on different pages. So it's not a site-wide markup. It's just only specific to the pages you add it to. So I'm going to add this to the page, and you guys can use this.